So let's go ahead. In this video, I want to look on 5 reasons why you should use it, a plan factory, and also who should use it, plan factory. Again, some applications can be work a little bit more flexible, maybe less, more variety and all this stuff. And we'll look on this application, won't necessarily compare them, because definitely something plus and minuses. We're going 5 reasons that may help you why you should use it, plan factory. And reason number 1, it is a price. Again, price not for everyone, but if you already subscribe to Voo, you'll notice you also have access to the plan factory. So it is savings in this case. You don't need to go and purchase separate application. So you can go ahead and it's come with complete package. And if you have Voo, you already have a plan factory. So it's reason number 1, you're saving, you don't buy extra. Number 2 reason, it's flexibility and integrations. Okay, let's speak a little bit about flexibility of this application. So right here as example, and again, I'm just bringing as example, a couple different applications. One will be SpeedTree and another one be XFrog. And I know it's many other ones have it very similarity. However, for example, SpeedTree, it's very powerful plan creation, and they have very good integrations with other ones like Cinema 4D, with Unity, Unreal Engine, so you can create a lot of those. Plans can also modify, they can be affect under shape, wind, all this you can program in. So this is very powerful. However, as I said before, you need purchase separately. And if you Voo user, they not necessarily integrated all the way those effects with the Voo. In the example, what I was saying by integration, it is like if we look on some parameters, and this tree does not utilize, but right here, if you look, you have a time and season. So you actually have a time, how old plant can be, and season. In some of my videos, tutorials, it's where we're using them, where we create a plant, they can actually growing, and plant can have it leaf, flowers, and change based on a season. I think actually I did even create a money tree at one time, and a money tree can grow from coins to the $100 bills or whatever some money you can put it, so you can do this. And the best parts about this is plants, all the parameters, everything you can animate it, very well integrated with the Voo itself. For example, right here, same tree, and you can see we can actually take a plant, take on a wind, and we can actually says, let's do crazy wind this way. And all physics will apply. Of course, if we have it leaves, it's applied to leaves and everything. And a wind is not just constant wind, which is nice about this. If we're going to edit atmosphere, we'll find right here in atmosphere properties, in a wind, we have it a breeze, we have it gauss, we have it all these different parameters like gauss, leaf, flooring, all these different things that highly mechanic and very realistic to do. And this all integrated. And just imagine you can create this, and you can also integrate it with other parameters inside to create interesting effect. And this, again, but integration, this is second reason what is going. Third reason, it's library. Library already exists plants. So if we're going right there and we click on load plants, you can see how large collection already plants exist. And the best part, your own software start giving away when you purchase, when you have this catalog of those plants. So you can actually have access to very large, highly detailed pre-build. Again, let's just compare to some other ones. And again, it's not necessarily comparison can be in good way, but of course you can go like XFrog. And for example, XFrog plants, I think they have the largest collection of the plants, period. They have it thousands, and they're very highly detailed. The textures is unbelievably everything, but they are static plants. And the static plants problem is, you have it like variety maybe of 5-6 plants, and it's already habit, and then not interact with the wind or seasons or age inside the application. So it's just like normal object static. You just put it there and they stay this way, which is lead us to number three elements. And this is procedural plans. So what does it mean, procedural plants? It is you creating species of the plants. And now if I add another tree here, you can see this is total tree. It's look from, okay, let me go ahead and put a tree, stop suffering from wind. Okay, we'll put right here. And here's another tree. And they look similar, but they're different, because they are same species, but there are different plants. And some of them, this is, for example, same height, but you can also do this, change height, how much you can have a teeny tiny tree, everything. This is one tree that does not build in when designers does not have it. But you can also program the plant, so every new plant, it can be anything from saplings to very old dying tree. You can do all this with seasoning and run this minimization. It's weird English word. Anyway, and you can do all of this. And this is the reason it is the procedural handling of the trees. Each tree are unique when you're creating. So none of them is same. And that is the biggest problem you find when you create, for example, plants and forests. And sometimes you notice, oh, that tree look exactly the same like this. And you just try, take that tree after and you try to rotate them, change a little bit angles, you know, take scale. So you try kind of adjust when you do same object populations. But again, with a plant factory trees, with those, you don't need it. They are realistic, they high details, and they are look very real in this case. Fourth reason, it is, again, we're going with integrations. If used in Vue, you don't need to go to another application to modify. So if you're going on a plant and you just open and you open the editor of the plant, you have parameters inside the Vue that you can modify. And notice right here, you also have it linking to your plant factory so you can create it. You can change your seeds. You can change even textures, lighting, colors, everything from here. You can create a very crazy plants, like gnarl, increase this one, reduce diameter. So you can create a very crazy, very interesting plants inside the Vue. And remember, even you change shapes inside, they still affect same on a wind, on a gust, it's exactly the same. You also can go and select like change leaves. If you have leaf, we can change the, for example, fur, we can change colors, width, links, all these different. And integration, it's not that they just integrate it with between applications, they also integrate it with function editor inside the Vue. So it's meaning as a sun going down, we can add glow effect and creating those, you know, glowing plants that start glowing on the middle of the night. You can animate this. So again, that is how the work inside the Vue, integrating with the plants. So above the just application, it's like one big giant. Okay. And our fifth reason, that is application that still actively develop. And this is one of those I put on a five, but in some cases it should be number one, because that is tell you, if you have a team behind who fixing, making new releases, making new updates, make new plans, and most important, creating new versions, add new features, you know this application will still there. You have a support, it's still something to invest your time. Because I have several applications that I love and they're very fun and excellent applications. And they're not necessarily even dead applications, but they are stop developing or developing very slow. And it's nice, but they start falling like behind. And some applications just, you know, excellent application and they drop out. So instead this, you can see the Plant Factory release quarterly, there is constantly new updates if you're on subscriptions. The catalogs of the plants, constantly new plants coming out. They're all updated. And of course, you can take these plants. Remember, they are exportables. Even before, you kind of lock, not anymore. Now you can have these plants and you can export them. You can sell them. And this is our bonus sixth reason is you can make money with this application. You can actually create the plant. You can export as OBG if you want for everyone. And you can sell them. Sell on a lot of different places. And by the licensing, you can do this. You cannot, of course, reuse plants that come with catalogs, but you can create it your own. And many other applications, you actually cannot do this. Even they provide all of this great stuff, but you actually need to use it. And sometimes use pay license per use. So it's a little bit different. So right here, you can create your plant. You can sell. You can make money. So actually, we come up with a six reasons instead of five. So I hope you enjoy this video. And I'm right now working on more tutorials for the Plant Factory. So if you guys stick around on my YouTube channel or geekatplay.com, you'll see some of those videos start coming up about Plant Factory. And I think this is one of the very interesting app. And if you're using Vue, you definitely want to learn Plant Factory. Thank you for watching this video.